As we've seen power levels climb increasingly higher in the diesel tuning market, it becomes apparent that at some point the factory components inside the engines aren't up to the task of putting up with all of that additional pressure inside the combustion chamber. At this point, we need to reach to stronger aftermarket components in order to maintain engine reliability. I'm here with Eric from Mahle Pistons, and we're going to talk about some of the aspects that go into the design of an aftermarket piston for the diesel tuning market. So Eric, for a start, the factory pistons that go into a diesel engine, there's obviously some strength considerations there. And once we get past what those pistons can put up with, we start reaching out to aftermarket pistons. There's a range of different production techniques or materials that can be used. And can we start with your cast piston? What's the advantages of a cast material when it comes to an aftermarket piston for a diesel application?
Well, particularly with the cast piston in a lower or entry-level diesel motorsports part, the biggest advantage of the cast piston is you retain the cast iron insert for the top ring groove. And that piece of the piston is the ultimate safety level for durability that you need. There's no way to duplicate it in any of the other types of pistons, and durability will suffer if that's not there. So even in a performance application, starting with a cast piston in a lot of those applications is the preferred method to use.
So can you just talk to us a little bit about what that insert is there for? How is that an advantage in both OE applications as well as your entry-level cast pistons? What's it actually do?
Yeah, most of the diesel pistons have a keystone or a dual keystone or at least a half keystone type ring that introduces radial motion of the ring to help clean the groove from carbon buildup. But that motion of the ring in the groove also can contribute to extremely high wear rates if you don't have a hard material there present to resist that wear. And that's the function of the insert. In most of the applications that we build where you're wanting that durability, you need to keep that cleaning function, that keystone style ring. So you've got to have that feature of the cast piston there to go hand in hand with it.
So if you'd move to a conventional sort of parallel style top compression ring, you're not going to get that cleaning effect. Is that correct?
Yes, and the biggest detriment to that, it'll seal up and make power, but durability would likely suffer.
Okay, so in the petrol tuning market, the cast pistons have a limit because the material tends to be brittle and under very high power levels, particularly in a petrol application, if we suffer any detonation, they can break. So in the diesel tuning market, where does the limit of a cast piston come in?
Yeah, we see lots of, 1,000 horsepower type truck engines that are still using cast pistons. The biggest advantage that the diesel piston has is there's so much more mass in that piston. It's well over designed. It's very robust. You don't have the limitations of very short compression heights and small, physical parameters in a gas engine or petrol engine, if you will, that you have in the diesels. So there's so much more mass there. You can design the diesel piston with the cast material to survive at higher power levels.
Now, moving up, if you're sort of beyond the capabilities of the cast piston, you do also offer a forged piston. So obviously what we've just talked about there with the insert for that top ring, with a forged material, it's impossible to incorporate that insert into the top ring.
Yep.
So then we get into that same problem we've just talked about with durability. So how do you deal with that?
Well, for our forged pistons, we do hard anodize the groove, which is still not as hard as the cast iron insert, but it's an improvement over the bare aluminum. The other aspect of the forged parts is we sell those as competition only type applications. Naturally, guys are going to run them on the street and do different things, but in a competition truck, whether it's a pulling truck or a drag truck, you're not looking for 100,000 mile durability, you're looking for performance. And there's things that we can do with added flexibility of the forge, starting from scratch, we're not limited to stock casting parameters. There's improvements that we can build into the forge, it's just not gonna get that long-term durability that you would see out of a cast piston that you might want for a street truck.
Now, traditionally, when we're talking about cast pistons, because of the way the material expands as it heats up, it allows a relatively tight piston-to-wall clearance to be maintained. And one of the problems with moving to some of the forgings, particularly 2618 material or the like with a low silicon content, is that those pistons do expand more as they heat up, requiring a higher piston-to-wall clearance. So can you talk about your own forged pistons and how the piston-to-wall clearance is affected?
No, that's all very true, and that's why one of the reasons that we build our pistons out of a material, it's a Mahle material that's very similar in expansion to the 4032, which is the lower expansion version, it's more similar to the cast piston, is so that we can reduce that overall expansion rate, and you're still keeping relatively tight clearances for what a diesel application would be, and not having to go to the far extremes where piston rock and, you know, things that that you're trying to compensate for, you know, which will also affect additional ring land wear and you know, movement of the pistons, trying to keep everything sealed when you're combating that extra expansion. We use the lower expansion alloy in our parts because it keeps everything fitting relatively nice and tight.
Now, when you go beyond the capability of your forged material, the forged aluminium material, moving to the top shelf, you've also got a steel application for some specific engines. So can you tell us about the advantages and maybe disadvantages with a full steel piston?
Yeah, definitely with the steel, it takes the question of durability off the table. There is no comparison between what you can do both in strength and the ability to handle heat with the steel. The downside of the steel is, although we've never failed one from cracking or actually physically breaking apart, you can still scuff it. And if the clearances aren't right and it scuffs, the other downside of the steel is it's much harder on the cylinder walls. The aluminum part will be more forgiving. It may scuff, tear up the piston, whereas the steel piston it's going to be pretty rough on the cylinder walls once it starts to scuff.
So unlike an aluminium forged piston, if you do scuff up a steel piston on the bore, you're probably going to be overboring the engine block?
There's a pretty good chance of it, yes.
Now, in terms of the expansion, though, of the steel material, it's likely, I'm assuming, to be much less than alloy. So how does that affect the optimal or ideal piston-to-wall clearances when you go from a forged aluminium piston to a steel piston?
Yeah, if we put it into the perspective that the average cast aluminum piston probably runs 5 to 6 thousandths piston to wall clearance, the forged parts with the low expansion alloy will still run 7 to 8. You know, the high expansion alloys, you're probably running 10 plus. The difference in the steel is you can start them out as tight as 2. And even on a very high output application, if you start getting above 4 thousandths clearance, it's too much for the part, just because the steel has nowhere near that expansion that you have to compensate for in the aluminum part.
So I'm guessing a lot of engine builders may struggle with specking a piston to wall clearance that's so tight it's sort of outside of their normal realm of experience.
The number one tech call we answer on the steel piston is convincing the guy that 2 thousandths to 3 thousandths isn't a typo. That is, it's not missing a digit or anything else. That is the actual recommended piston to wall clearance.
So in terms of that material, obviously it's a denser material than aluminium. So how does that affect the overall piston weight?
The piston itself is much heavier, but through different design changes, because the structures are also different, we can take out weight in the overall combination. If you hold the aluminum piston to the steel piston is always going to be heavier. But if you look at the pin design on the two, there's a lot of weight that can be taken out of the pin. So when you look at the combined mass that's hanging on the end of the rod, we can get pretty close to balancing it to what a factory cast piston and pin combination weighs.
Now, I guess with the lower rev limits used by traditional diesel engines, the weight is maybe not quite so critical as a high RPM gasoline engine?
No, very true. But there's guys that will still spin, you know, a Cummins six-cylinder steel piston, 6,000 RPM. So not as critical as 10, but it's manageable.
So the other thing I wanted to ask about there is also the design of the bowl or dish, if you like, in the top of the piston. So this really, for a diesel engine, it becomes part of the combustion chamber, essentially. We see with a lot of the OE design pistons that that bowl is sort of undercut on the outside edge. And there's a belief that that can lead to reliability problems with the piston. And I see that all of your Mahle pistons, forged or cast or steel, all use a parallel side to that bowl. So can you just tell us a little bit about that design feature?
Yeah, definitely that area over the bowl is the number one region of failure. If you imagine the piston under pressure, the gas pressure is trying to bend that piston over the pin. So in that axis along the pin is where the highest stress is going to be. The edge of that bowl is always going to be the highest temperature on the piston. So you're combining the highest stress area with the highest temperature area and adding the stress concentration that occurs when you neck down the material and have the overhang. So we eliminate that stress concentration. The factory design pistons, they shape the bowl for combustion, for emissions and different parameters, but the guys that are tuning these for the aftermarket are using different fuel strategies, different injectors, adding more fuel, air, etc. So all that work that they put into that bowl design to fit under those parameters kind of goes out the window. So we take the default approach of let's take the stress concentration out, let the guys use the tuning and their ability to work around, you know, the smoke issues and the emissions parts and make the part as strong as we can, which is ultimately that straight wall type design.
Look, that's been really interesting to get some more insight into what goes into a performance diesel piston design. Great to also find out the differences between those cast alloy, forged alloy, and your steel pistons. And if people want to find out more about Mahle diesel piston applications, where can they go to?
We actually have some more informative videos on YouTube. Mahle Motorsport North America has a channel as well, or definitely go to the website. And there's direct contact information, or they can call us at the office, and we'll talk to them about any questions they may have.
Oh, that's great. Look, thanks for the chat. Really been interesting finding out more about that.
No, thank you very much.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.